first episode of Inside Neosho Athletics. I'm Mike Sadler. We're 1 month into the first semester, and fall sports are in full swing. Volleyball and soccer are starting to get into the meat of their conference schedule, and cross country has its first race under the belt. Basketball and wrestling are going to be coming up in no time, but before that, let's take a look at what's going on so far in our fall sports. Men's soccer is off to a 5-3 start overall, and they're 2-1 in conference. Much of that success is due to freshman keeper Ryan Davis, who's been outstanding in both of the Panthers. Davis is 5-3 overall and has recorded 3 shutouts so far this season, which is good for 8th in the nation. Returning leading scorer Nelson Landeberry continues to power the Panther offense, which is much improved this season. Last year, the Panthers only had 5 players score 5 points or more, and they've already matched that so far this season in only 8 games. This week kicks off a busy schedule for the men, who will travel to KCK Wednesday for a matchup with the Blue Devils before a trip to St. Louis over the weekend with games on Saturday against St. Louis Community College and Sunday against St. Charles Community College. After the busy week, they'll have a full week to prepare for their next home game, which is on October 5th when they host Coffeyville. Volleyball is 10-7, 2-2 so far in conference this year, with a team that's not necessarily young, but somewhat inexperienced. They relied very heavily on their stellar sophomore class last year, and there's been some growing pains in the early going for the Panthers, but they're beginning to find their stride, and they're being led so far by freshman Jill Scarlett. 3 of the 7 losses so far for the Panthers have come to teams ranked in the top 15 of the NJCAA. Now, Starling has been outstanding on the court for the Panthers. She leads the team in kills and digs, and has also recorded the team best 7 double-doubles so far this season. Now, they have a very tough stretch of games coming up, where they will host number 11 Cali on Wednesday the 24th at 6:30, before a 6:30 start against number 15 Fort Scott on the 29th, which will be a rematch. The Panthers lost earlier this season to Fort Scott at the Allen Invite. Women's soccer is also off to a great start this year. They're 5-3 overall, 2-2 in JAC conference play. The 5 wins through the first 8 games already surpasses the win total from last season. The Panthers started the year 3-0 before back-to-back losses in double overtime. Kind of took some momentum away, but they're now back on track. They've won 2 of the last 3, including an 8-0 shutout over Cali last week. The women will also travel to KCK Wednesday before returning home for a very tough match against Butler this Sunday. They'll take on the Grizzlies at 3 p.m. The women are much improved this season, and the offense is a large part of that. The Panthers are just 2 goals shy of tying their season total from last year, and we're less than halfway through this season. Now, the Panther offense is led by sophomore Haylie Kinzey. Kinzey had 11 goals last year for the Panthers and already has 9 so far this season, following a 4-goal game against Cali last week. So we're joined by Haylie this week on our player spotlight. So Haylie, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
Now, you and the Panthers are off to a great start. What's been the key for the good start, both for you as an individual and for the team?
The good start for us is, and the keys are that we've come in ready to play, we're ready to win. We all know what we have to do individually and as a team, and we just want to go and get that national title.
All right. Now, what about for you as an individual? What's been the key to your hot start? Almost matched your goal total from last season. You had the 4-goal game against Cali last time out. What's been the key for you?
The key for me had to be that I knew I had to come in ready to play, ready to win. And I want to showcase myself for others to see, hey, this is how college soccer needs to, needs to be played. It's not a low-key sport. It needs to be hard-driven. You gotta know what you want.
Okay, good. Now, coming into the season, what were some of the goals that you set for yourself and that you had for the team this year?
For myself, I knew that I had to score. I had to hit them early and get them in the back of the net. But, I mean, it's been kind of difficult for me, and I've had lots of chances. But for me individually, I just want to make my team proud and make my family proud, and that's really all that matters for me. But for my team, I can't ask anything better for them except for to give me 100%, and I'll give them 100% because they're just like my family. And with family, I'll do anything for them, and I know that whenever it comes down to it, they'll do anything for me.
That's great. Now, the way the schedule's played out, 4 conference games in, many of the conference games are coming against teams towards the bottom half of the conference, so a tough schedule coming up. What's going to be some of the keys for you as you move through the rest of the conference schedule to secure our playoff spot and to get a deep run in the playoffs?
Yeah, we have a tough bunch of games coming up. We have Butler coming up this weekend. I think that what's going to be key for us is that we're going to have to keep our heads on straight and just focus on what needs to be done. The task ahead, not looking toward down the line, we just need to focus on the games that we have at hand and not worry too much about who's there, what's going on outside of the field. Once we step on that pitch, we know that it's going to be difficult down the next couple of games, so we just have to stay focused and know what we want.
All right. Now, 9 games left in the regular season, hopefully a deep run in the playoffs at the end of that. So what's next for Haylie Kinzey when you get done at Neosho County? What's the plans after here?
Haylie, it's probably going to be soccer, hopefully soccer. I want to get a scholarship somewhere. If that doesn't happen, then I'll try and walk on somewhere, hopefully, good enough. But if not, then I'll just end up being a zoologist and hanging out with animals all day.
Well, hopefully the season continues to progress the way it has so far. You've been great. Keep winning. Enjoy watching you play. It's been a great season, so I'd like to keep it going. So thank you for joining us today, and best of luck to you the rest of the way.
Thanks for having me.
Now, you can catch Haylie and the Panthers in action Sunday the 28th at 3 p.m. when they host Butler. And don't forget, coming up October 8th, very special event. That's the first time this will be done, is we'll have a unique doubleheader of sorts. The women will be taking on Coffeyville in volleyball at 6:30 p.m. And immediately following that will be the 2014 edition of Panther Madness, which will give fans their first look at the men's and women's basketball team. The contest for the fans, performances by the Neosho Spirit Squad, as well as scrimmages by the men and women. Now that is volleyball at 6:30, Panther Madness immediately following the game there. So don't miss that. It's a unique doubleheader, but something we're very excited about. We'd like to pack the gym for volleyball and have a full house for Panther Madness. That'll do it for this episode of Inside Neosho Athletics, presented by Service Office. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.